Hey, let's just try a real quick demonstration of what we're doing in grade 11 essential. All right, it's 13 November. Today I'm planning a warm-up, the rule of 72, and I want you to read ahead personal loans. All right, but let's just do a warm-up. We did a lot of stuff. We're starting the, some students are starting remote learning. So there was the workbook. Hopefully you've been working in that. The workbook doesn't use the fancy formula. I taught you the fancy formula so that you could do the workbook a lot quicker. So there was one example there, lesson two, simple interest. We did all that stuff. Hopefully you've done the workbook. Let's do the compound interest. Compound interest, engage. So just warm up. You've already done bits of this, I hope, by now. Okay, so this was like lesson three. You've had this for a week. You would have done some of this by now, I hope. So this was the compound interest. This is the way they show it in the workbook. But of course, then I showed you a better way to do it with a formula. But in the way they show you in the workbook is you calculate every period. So you do simple interest for the first year. Then that principal amount becomes augmented by the interest you earned in the first year, and then you do simple interest in the second year, and then you do simple interest in the third year, and you just keep going and going line by line. It's a lot of work, but of course you know that the interest formula, the compound interest formula, is a lot better. So there we go. You're going to use the compound interest formula. Make sure you add this to your cheat sheet. You are expected to have a cheat sheet on the final exam. The final exam, you are expected to have a single page, both sides, cheat sheet. Pay attention to what the symbols mean in a formula. A formula is absolutely useless unless you know what the symbols mean and what the units are. This is dollars, dollars. This is a percentage per year, a percentage per year. This is the number of years, and the S is the compounding period, how frequently you calculate the interest owing every year. So if something's done annually, if you do it once a year, that is a 1. If something is done quarterly, that's 4 times a year. If something is done daily, that's 365 times a year. All right, let's do this one then. Here's another example in the warm-up. So that was in your workbook. Notice how, if you do it the iterative way, line by line for each one-year period, because we're doing it for one-year periods here. We start out simple. If you do it line by line for each one-year period, you get the exact same answer when you use the calculator. Oh, isn't it? It's a lot easier to do this than it is to do line by line for every year. Neat, eh? Compound interest. So this was lesson three. Here was some of the examples they gave. If I do it that silly iterative method, it's going to look like this. All right, so if I invest $500 at 6% for the first year, right, because this is done annually, so we're going to calculate each line per year, for 1 year, I would earn $30. So now I had 500, I add the 30, I now have a total amount of $530. Now I start year two with $530. And that extra 30 that I earned last year is going to earn interest too. So now my interest is $3180 in the second year. So now I have the 530 that I started the second year with, adding the 3180 interest that I gained during the second year. Now I have a total of 561.80. All right, so you could do it that way. Or you could just have fun and go to town and use your calculator like this. This is a lot funner. Look at that. You get the same answer a lot quicker and a lot more reliably. You're less likely to make a mistake. So the next time I see you, let's make sure that we get you to download this calculator. Anybody with an Android phone or an Android tablet, this is going to be the go-to calculator. It's free if you have an Android. Make sure you see me the next Friday you pop in. And here's one last example of compound interest. We'll do it the iterative, recursive method, line by line, just to show you that it does work. The compound interest formula works. Are you ready? Here we go. Boom. So did you do that? You should be familiar with doing it both ways. Watching me do it is not going to help you. You have to actually be doing some of these. Watching somebody else do it is not a good way to learn. You got to get your hand going. You got to get your mouth going. You got to hear yourself talking as you do it. That's called learning. Watching me do this for you on a video is not going to learn you. Make sure you're doing all of this yourself. And I hope you noticed that I had a whole bunch of other links on our webpage. There's links you can click there, and every bank has a website where they'll calculate your interest or your loans and stuff like that. So make sure you check out the rest of my page. There's all kinds of nice extra little links to support your learning, because this is your learning. So hopefully you are investigating these so that you will learn. Rule of 72, that's today's main lesson. Read and do. All right, did you read all of that stuff about Rule of 72? Every banker and real estate guy knows this. Most people know how to calculate. Anybody that's had anything to do with money can do this in their head. And here's the idea. So if you invest money at 2%, it takes 36 years to double, because 2 times 36 is 72. So if this times this is 72, then your money doubles. And one good way to test it is just test. Sometimes the best way to figure out if something's true is to test it and see if it works. So let's do it for $1. Let's plug in $1 and see if 2% interest for 36 years doubles my money. And it does. Look. So according to this, I could take $1 and 2% interest for 36 years, my money pretty much doubles, right? $2.04 is pretty much a double one. So it's an approximate formula, but it's really, really close. How about if we did it for 6%? How many years? 6 times what is 72? I think 6 times 12 is 72. Let's just see if that works. If I put my money in the bank for 12 years at an interest rate of 6% per year, let's test it with $1 and see if it works. Because if it works for $1, it'll work for $1,000. Let's see if it doubles every 12. Here we go. I'm going to test it. Look at that. Hey, I turned my $1 into $2.01. That's pretty darn close to being double. This is awesome. Try it again. So I hope you've been doing these, right? Watching me do these is not going to help you. All right, so let's see. Say I'm going to retire in 15 years and I want to double my money. Maybe I got like $20,000 that I won on a game show or something. And I want to put it in the bank and I want it to double in 15 years when I retire. So what annual percentage rate will I need if I want to double my money in 15 years? All right, so 15 times what is 72? 15 times what is 72? Well, it's 4.8%, or 0.048. 4.8%. Well, let's plug it into our plastic brain and see if we can convert $1 into $2-ish. Let's plug in the 4.8%. Here we go. Here we go. Are you ready? Have you already done this? I hope you're pausing and doing this. I hope you're not just watching me do it. Look at that. We pretty much doubled our money. So you can do the rest of those in the table. And if it doubles your money, you probably did it right. All right, so here's our next lesson. One we'll be doing on the next lesson, so Monday. Personal loans. Read ahead. Figure out how personal loans work. All right, you're going to be using this table. Read ahead. Check out our unit playlist. I have a unit playlist with all kinds of related videos for the unit. Check out all our links in the Unit B webpage. Check out the videos in our YouTube playlist. Watch my blog daily. Check in daily at the beginning of class for attendance and participation. If you don't check in, you get marked absent. Of course, some of you are supposed to still be in class. Pop by on Friday afternoons with completed assignments for myself and your English teacher. Be smart. Be smart. Okay, here we go. That was it today. 13 November.